Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we do some practice programs in Python. In our previous classes, we already did so many practice examples. All these examples will help you a lot in improving your coding skills so that you can easily crack the placement exams. So please follow our playlist. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, and one more thing, you can visit our website learningmonkey.in and you can take the placement practice tests. Okay, coming to today's example, our suggestion is to try to take the question, try to solve it on your own, then check for the solution. So coming to the question, adding binary strings, this is our question. So the input is, what's the input we have to take? Two binary strings of same length. So here we are discussing it, that the input should be of the same length. You have to take two strings which are having the binary values. So 1010 string should be taken and the two strings should be on the same length. So what happens if they are not in the same length? That we will discuss at the end of the class. So as of this logic, we have to take the input, that two strings of same length. So output should be, add the two binary strings. These two binary strings should be added and the output, the result which we get after adding, that should be displayed as a string. In the string format, you have to display that. That is what the output you have to display. Okay, let's take an example so that you will understand better. Then you will try to write the code on your own, then check for the solution. Example, see, we are taking two strings. 1011 is one string. The second string is 3110 is another string. If you add these two strings, this is the, so we are not discussing about how to add all those things. And these are the basics which come under digital logic design number system. Please watch our DLD playlist number system section. Then come back here if you are not good at what's binary addition, all those things. So after adding this, you are getting 1 1 0 1. So even the carry should also, if the carry value is 1, you have to add that one also. That is what the output you have to display. If the carry value is 0, no need to add that. If the carry value is 1, then only add that value. Okay, that is what the output you have to get. Okay, coming to the solution, we'll discuss about the logic. Let's try to understand how to do addition. If you take the two strings, so if you add these two strings, 1 0, what's the sum value? 1. What's the carry value? 0. So placing 0 here, there will be no change. That's why we are not placing 0 here. So if you add 1 0, the output will, the sum value will be 1 and the carry value will be 0. 1 1, the sum value will be 0 and the carry value will be 1. So what's this? We are not discussing all those things. So 1 1, carry value will be, sum value will be 0 and the carry value will be 1. So 1 0 1, here we are adding 3-bit addition. Along with carry, we are adding 3-bit addition. So 1 0 1, what's the sum? 0. What's the carry value? 1. 1 1 1, what's the sum? 1. What's the carry value? 1. So we are having a carry of 1. So we drop it here and we'll display this output. So what we have to do here, we have to do 3-bit addition. If you write the logic for, if you identify the logic from the addition, what's the 3-bit addition is. So the logic which we are confirming here, we are discussing here. So we are using some logic, you can do any other logic. So we are taking 3-bit addition logic. Initially the carry is not there, we are defaultly taking it as 0. So based on that we are, so let's identify the logic, how the logic will be. So if the 3 bits are, see, these are the 2 bits, additionally we are adding a carry. So total how many bits we are having? 3-bit addition. So if the 3 bits are all zeros, what's the sum value? 0. What's the carry value? 0. If 3 bits are all ones, what's the sum value? 1. What's the carry value? 1. If 3 bits are, one of the bit is 1, not only this bit, if the one, if this bit is 1 and this bit is 0, one of the bit in these 3 bits are 1, remaining 2s are zeros, then the sum will be 1 and the carry will be 0. So 2 of the bits in the given 3 bits are 1s, then sum will be 0, carry will be 1. This is the logic. So simple, if, else if, else if, else, this is the condition. So loop on the strings, take the bits one by one, do this logic. using the if else conditions, take the sum value and take the carry value. This carry value should be used in the next iteration also. That is the point you have to understand. The carry value is taken as the next loop's iteration carry value. So that you should be remembered. So how to write the logic? Coming to the coding part. See, we are taking two input strings S1, S2, string length, and we are taking the string length. So both the strings are of same length. Why we are taking the string length value? Because we have to loop on the strings until the string length value. And one more thing, see here we are taking one more list one to in order to place the sum values. And we are taking C is equal to 0. C means carry value. Initially it is 0. And we are looping on the strings. We are looping on the strings from back to front. Why we are looping on the back to front? Let's check the output. So this is our string addition. So this is the starting of the string. This is the starting of the string. But we have to do addition from this side to this side. That's why we have to loop on the strings from back to front. We already know how to move the loop from back to front on the strings using string slicing, and there are so many ways. So we discussed all these basic things when we discussed about the strings, how to move in the strings from back to front. So take the string from string one, take this value from string two, take this value. Carry value is already considered as 0. Apply the logic. Change the sum value. Sum value is placed in the list. Carry value is placed in the C value. The same C value is used in the next loop. Take these two bits and C will be taken from the previous carry value. So C, again apply the loop, apply the condition like that, so on, do it. That is what the logic we are applying. You can identify different logic according to your wish. So for J in the range of S length minus 1 minus 1 minus 1, so we are looping from back to the front and we are taking the position, last position elements. How to take the last position elements? S1 of S1 means string 1 of jth position element is placed in B1, S2 of jth position element is placed in B2. So we are having values in B1 and B2, and another value is placed in C. Okay, so what's the logic? After taking the B1 and B2 values, B1 is equal to 0, B2 is equal to 0. If three values are 0, list 1 dot append of sum is placed in list 1. So we are appending 0 and C is modified as 0. Else if both all the values are 1s, append 1, sum value is 1, carry value is appended to C value 1. If at one of the bit is 1, so we are having three options here. How it will be? One of the bit will be 1. B1 is equal to 1, B2 is equal to 0, C is equal to 0, or B1 is equal to 0, B2 is equal to 1, and C is equal to 0, or what's the third option? B1 is equal to 0 and B2 is equal to 0 and C is equal to 1. If any of these conditions satisfies, means we are having at most one position in any of the three bits. If that logic is applied, list 1 dot append of 1 means sum value is 1, carry is equal to 0. Else, what's the else condition? Two bits are 1s. Then list 1 dot append of 0, C is equal to 1. This is how, if you loop inside all the string values, all the string characters one by one, after coming out of the loop, if C is equal to 1, append it to the list. So we have to do that logic also. If the carry is 1, you have to take that 1 into consideration. If C is equal to 1, list 1 dot append of, but we have to display it in string format. So what we do, we will join them. So we use the string join method to join the all the values. Z is equal to join of list 1 of minus 1. What's this string slicing method? Take the values from reverse. So that is the logic you have to identify, because we place it from the beginning. So first we have added the last values. So those values should be come to the last position. In order to come, now take that values in the last position, reverse the string list, reverse the list, reversing the list. This is the way we will reverse the list and convert into string format. That is how we are converting. So the output will be, enter your binary string 1011, enter second binary string 3110, output will be 11001. So this is the logic we applied. Hope you understand the concept and take the output. So that you can easily practice this. Note down the code. And the last conditions also. Okay. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.